Hi guys, Munoz here. So today is just a mini rant about the PACRA migration to the e-government portal. PACRA has been one of my favorite government or quasi-government sites. I use it a lot. I do a lot of PACRA work and it's been great. I do understand they needed to do some upgrades and some movements and all, but the implementation has simply been terrible. There are a few benefits to it migrating to there, but the way it's been done is what I totally do not agree with. Oh, and don't mind the artwork behind. The little Picassos are doing their artwork here. I'll probably sell them as NFTs later. But anyways, back to this. So this is the PACRA website. It's been a great website. A lot of people don't like it, but I actually loved it. I still love it. If they come back, I'll love it still. There was this little notice here, which I think if you go to the PACRA website, most people would actually come here. None of them would scroll all the way down here to look at the latest notices. Probably a design flaw. I mean, they should have probably been having a pop-up window that irritates you and tells you we're migrating. But here they basically said PACRA migrates to the government service portal. And the way they did it, it's a really, really bad way. A lot of people, myself inclusive, had or have information in the PACRA portal, would log in and would be able to get all our client or customer information readily available. We did not have sufficient notice or time to migrate all of that data. They're in PDF. We could have simply saved them off the site if had we known that we're not going to have access after the migration. I actually did call PACRA and I was told that all the information was going to be migrated to the government portal. So I didn't think much of it. But after that, when you try to log in here, it actually takes you to the government portal. And then here, the government portal, there are a few things I'll talk about. Before I talk about that, let me just say the actual benefit of moving to this government portal is on the payments. On the PACRA site, you could only pay by debit card. On the government portal, you can pay by debit card, bank transfer, and you can also pay via mobile money. So you've got more payment options on the government portal than you did on the PACRA portal. And all that said, this is like a really, really, really hard reboot. You know, you're just forced onto this. And that's when now you discover, a lot of people will probably discover that PACRA stands for Patents and Companies Registration Agency. I know a lot of people don't know what PACRA stands for, the same way a lot of people don't know what RATSA stands for, whether it's RATSA with an A or RATSA with an RT. A lot of people don't know these things. So the assumption that people would automatically be able to just migrate and start using a portal without issue is a really, really terrible take on IT. They should have run this parallel systems and all. Right now, there's a fourth wave of COVID. I mean, people are forced to go and queue up at PACRA. It's really important during this COVID wave that people try to do everything online as much as possible, and this is not helping. Now, when you come here, one of the things, most people would just come automatically to where they have been redirected and make an assumption that this is where things are done. Some will just come straight here and click on annual return, not knowing that it's actually annual return to registrar of societies. So all the government bodies are here. It's not just PACRA. So the first thing you need to do is come here under service provider and change or just pick the one that you want. In this case, it's Patents and Companies Registration Agency. A lot of people automatically, I know, will be looking for PACRA and they won't find PACRA. They'll actually pick up the phone to phone PACRA or they'll go to PACRA itself because they're not seeing PACRA. Because many people simply do not know that PACRA is Patents and Companies Registration Agency. It's not their fault. It is what it is. So once you put PACRA and you apply filters, you then now come to the next issue, which a lot of people are going to have issue with, and that is filing an annual return. One of the simple things people want to do on PACRA is pay their annual returns. So here you're going to search through all this. There's 21 services. You're going to search through all these. It's just two pages. So here you've got, people are going to see here annual return, receipt of statement of account. If you come to the second page, you won't see any annual return here. So what is going to happen is people are going to click here on annual return, receipt of statement of account. Okay, so it brings you to this page here, annual return receipt of statement of accounts. Then if you click on apply for service, that's what any rational person would do. It's going to bring you to this page here. So it's going to show your NRC number there, and here you can choose amendment or what. So now here where it says organization ID, BIN, or the business registration number. So what's going to happen is most people do not know their business registration number. That is a 12 or 13 digit company number. For all those people whose companies are old and they have those 5-digit old certificate numbers, they will have to start phoning PACRA. Then PACRA will tell them, we can't give this information over the phone. They'll have to go to queue up at PACRA. There's COVID right now, the fourth wave. It's hitting everybody. They'll have to queue up there just to get their business registration number and do this in person. In case you do know your business registration number and you paste it, you'll see here that nothing is going to cut. So it's going to tell you that here, this application requires you to be an authorized user. Please close this window from the top menu, switch from personal profile to corporate profile. Now, this absolutely does not make sense because at the top of the window here, you've seen there's just my profile here. We're going to come to it, and you'll see that there's absolutely nothing there. If not available, click here to register as an authorized user. Now, if you click on that, it's going to bring you to this screen here. And what any rational person will do is they'll paste the company number there, then they'll query it. And it's going to show this, NRC record not found. So what's going to happen, most rational people will pick up the phone, call PACRA, clog up the PACRA call center, and if they can't get help there, they're going to go and queue up at any of the PACRA offices. Remember, there's a fourth wave out. COVID fourth wave is out. Others are going to come here to the top where it said go to the corporate profile. So here under profile, you just got my profile and ZAMPASS logout. If you come to notifications, nothing there. So what you're actually supposed to do is you're supposed to click here on my workplace. You're actually supposed to click on my workplace. Now you're going to come to this part here, and it's sorted, I think, alphabetically. So it starts with Department of Immigration. If I scroll up, you'll see here that there's 14 pages, the 132 records, 14 pages. So if you are going to be going next, you see that it's just going department by department. So obviously, as a rational person, you're going to come here and you're going to type PACRA. And that's what you're going to search for. There will be no record for PACRA because PACRA is not what it saved at in this system. So obviously, since you don't know the full name of PACRA, you'll be like, oh, the P stands for patents. Let me check patents. It's not going to be there. So two things will happen. Or is it three things will happen? One, you'll pick up the phone, clog up the PACRA call center line. Two, you're going to go to PACRA offices and queue up during the fourth wave of COVID. The third thing you can do is you're going to go through these one by one by one, looking for PACRA, which is absolutely not necessary. I've gone through all of them so that you don't have. Oh, it actually starts on number 7. Okay, yes, so PACRA starts on number 7, not number 6. So here, when you come to PACRA number 6, now this is where you start finding these things. And this is where you're going to find one of the first things is no change annual return. So you can click on that. This is just for the annual return. Three things are going to happen. One, you spend the entire day clicking here and nothing is going to happen. You pick up the phone PACRA, clog up their phone lines, go to PACRA offices with your laptop, queue up during the fourth wave of COVID, or you now start exploring and then you'll be like, wait a second, there's this here, apply for service. Let me click on apply for service. And when you click on apply for service, that's when it gets activated. Okay, so it brings you to this screen. Your NRC is going to show there. And let's just let it load. I'm using velocity and the speed sucks. Zamtel, please work on your internet. Okay, so you then come up to this screen where you can basically file a no change annual return. You put in the business registration number if you have it. You query it. The name of the business pops up here. You click on next. Or you need to put in a case type, sorry. You put in new, you click on next, and you get all the business information, the date of registration. So now the date of registration, the date of registration, and then here you can click on next. So it's asking you to pick the years. If you click on that, it's going to give you up to 1 year, for 1 year up to 2020, since it's a 2020 company. You click on that, then you save and close. Then if you click on next, it then brings you to this screen here where you are able to see and preview the invoice. You can preview the invoice if you want, or you can actually just make a payment. So as you can see, you've got options of paying by online banking, debit card, or mobile banking. So this, just on the payment part, it's an improvement from the PACRA system. You also have the issue of when you log into this, PACRA does not take you to this part here where you can apply for the services. It takes you to the other page where there are other services, and that annual return which you find there is different from this annual return which you find on this one. So it's just this simple thing is going to lead to a lot of unnecessary phone calls at PACRA, a lot of site visitations at PACRA during the fourth wave of COVID. Now, another very, very simple issue, which will be very, very problematic, is there's a sort of loss of freedom of information. Because initially on PACRA, you could actually come on the site in case you're looking for information on a business. It was really, really simple and straightforward to get a PACRA printout. You just come on the PACRA site, you log in, you do a search for the business, and then you could pay for the printout and you'd get it into your profile. You download it, print it. That was very good for journalists, investigative journalists who are doing a splendid job investigating financial malpractices here and there. It was good for banks and financial institutions to know the shareholding, directorship of businesses and the likes. It's also good for people who forgot their company details and wanted to get the printouts and all. And also good for those who, right now, FNB has been asking a lot of corporate clients to bring in the latest printouts. Now, how are you supposed to get your latest printout if you don't know your business registration number? I know a lot of people will laugh and say, no, you're supposed to know your business registration number. But the reality is, a lot of people contract company secretarial services to others. And then those people who are doing the company secretarial services, they won't be keeping box files and box files and box files in their offices and what. A lot of them work from home, work from remote locations. So they had everything saved and stored within the PACRA portal. They would simply log in, retrieve the information for the client and send it to them. Right now, that cannot be done. So come January, when a lot of people are going to need to file annual returns, a lot of people are going to need to submit the latest PACRA printouts to wherever it's requested, there's going to be a whole host of people struggling and suffering for no other simple reason than that this migration has locked people out of their PACRA profiles. And people cannot do the simple tasks that they used to do on the PACRA website, on the government portal website. So that is going to be a huge, huge problem. So I really hope and pray that PACRA sees the light, gives people like myself and other users access to their PACRA portals so that they can migrate the data out of there and do the necessary works they're supposed to do. And then also, PACRA and government portal need to understand that it's not all the time that people are going to have their business registration numbers. A lot of times it's a simple fact of their business is old. The business registration number they have on their company certificates is showing the old 5-digit format and not the new 12 or 13-digit format. So how are they supposed to find their business registration number in that case? It's really unfair that people need to be phoning PACRA or going to PACRA offices to do things that they could easily or simply do from home just a few weeks ago. So anyways, that's my rant. I hope things get sorted out, and I really hope when Zambian platforms are doing upgrades or changes, I hope they consider the end users. I mean, the employees of these organizations are not end users. They are people who use the platforms. They'll always see things from their point of view, which is as employees, but the end users are the ones who are going to struggle with these platforms, who are going to clog up their phone lines, queue up in their offices during COVID times. Imagine having to stand outside in a mask for hours on end simply to get your business registration number or to do a company printout. It really is not fair. So I hope changes can be done and will be done so that at least business should continue. Anyways, let me know your views. Thanks for watching. Bye.